Hello and welcome to this small demo video. I wanted to introduce Dpaint.js. Dpaint.js is a browser-based image editor with a huge sweet spot for the Commodore Amiga. And in this demo, I wanted to highlight these Amiga-specific features. Well, I started this project as a sort of modern editor for Amiga icons, so let's start with that. Dpaint is mainly aimed for creating pixel art and working with a limited color palette. There are some widely used palettes included, and one of them being the 8-color palette of the Magical User Interface package, which is, of course, more or less the default color palette for classic Amiga icons. Just like the Lux Paint, we can have a 2-pane window with instant preview and different zoom levels. Setting the preview to icon, just creating a very quick icon here. This is a good opportunity to show a very cool pixel feature, the dithered gradient. So this is a normal gradient of two colors, which is fine, but not for pixel art. But if you activate the dither option, you get this. Very handy because, well, doing this by hand is super time consuming. Adding a second one. As you can see, we have layers and selections and masks and stuff. Using the flood fill. Fiddly diddly doo. Just adding some more details. Okay, that's good for now. Let's copy it to another frame. And one of the reasons to create my own image editor is that I wanted a straightforward way of adding your own scriptable effects. You can find some examples in the Alchemy tab, and they basically give you an input and output canvas that you can use to unleash your automated effects that you can write in JavaScript. In this case, I want to add the frequently used glow effect for the clicked state of the icon. Okay, so let's export it. There are various export options, but in this case we're going for a classic Amiga icon, which can be displayed on any Amiga system. So let's give it a name. And let's fire up our Amiga emulator to see how it looks as an actual Amiga system. By the way, I've mapped the folder where I'm saving these files as a drive in WinUAE for ease of access. Okay, there's our icon. And let's undo that last step and go for some more color. Let's first darken the image a bit and edit the script to use the default color icon's glow, the yellow one. Export it as color icon. Update the window on the Amiga side, and there's the second icon in color icon format. These can be displayed by default on OS 3.1.4 or up, or if you install, for example, a new icon library on any older system. Okay, next cool Amiga feature. You can directly read and write files from ADF files, the Amiga disk format. For example, a nice one to open is the Glow Icons disk that comes with Amiga OS 3.2, because it contains a lot of icons. So you can open any ADF file as a disk. So you can directly edit them from disk. Another nice example is the demo disk from the Peter K. icon library, because it contains all sorts of icon types like new icons and PNG icons, OS4 icons. And these last two formats support full alpha layer transparency. But let's say you want to use these nice icons on an older system. Well, you can't just save them as classic or color icons because they have too much colors. But you can convert them and reduce the amount of colors. I specifically wanted to highlight this alpha threshold slider, which determines what the transparency level is that is still included in the converted icon. Let's switch to the icon preview pane. As you can see on the three different background colors, the transparency of the border pixels can really make or break a good icon. And this is needed because, of course, classic icons and color icons, well, they do support transparency, but it's on-off. It's not a full alpha layer like the later formats support. Repeat for the clicked state image and export it as color icon. Back on the Amiga side, there's our converted icon. And to round up this feature, if you open an icon from an ADF disk, let's take the Deluxe Paint 3 one, and just quickly change some colors here. So if you open an icon from an ADF disk, you can also directly write the updated icon back to that disk. Now your original ADF file doesn't get touched. Well, that's something a web app just can't do. But if you're done, you can download the ADF again, and that will include your changes. So let's fire up the Amiga again and load the disk we just downloaded. And there's our edited icon. Of course, you're not limited to icons. Dpaint.js also supports IFF ILBM images in all formats. And a good example disk of that is the second disk of Deluxe Paint 4. This is an HAM image, for example. Another HAM. And a big 32 color one. And the default low res one. And of course, modern image formats are also supported, like PNG and JPEG files. For example, this WebP image of a flower. So let's convert this to an old school Amiga image. Reduce the size. Reduce the amount of colors. There are various dithering mechanisms provided, which will give a different result. And another very cool feature, if you're feeling nostalgic, is you can preview your work in the real Deluxe Paint on Amiga, using an embedded Amiga emulator right in your browser, which is of course based on the fabulous scripted Amiga emulator project by Rupert Hausbrigger. So this is Deluxe Paint 2 from 87. Useful? Probably not. Cool? Oh yeah! Okay, back to 2023, saving it as IFF image. And let's open it on Amiga. I have to show all files, of course. And there it is. Okay, final Amiga trick. When we reduce the colors, we can also opt to map the image to a specific palette. For example, again, the ubiquitous MUI one. Trying out some different dithers. Okay, this one. Let's quickly cut out some parts. Move it down a bit. Save it as IFF. Dpaint.js will automatically use the minimum amount of bit planes, so if you're only using 8 colors, your IFF file will only use 3 bit planes. And now we have a nice workbench background that any old system can display. Ah, this is Carlos, not workbench. Yep, here. And there we go. Okay, there we have it, highlighting some Amiga-specific features of Dpaint.js. You can try it out for yourself, there's a demo online. It's still a bit in alpha phase though, so bugs and missing features will still be there. But bug reports and feature requests are most welcome. Thanks for watching.